package.
In the history of recorded music, there is a very short list of legendary studio combos that have earned their names as backing groups extraordinaire. The Wrecking Crew, the Funk Brothers, and Booker T and the MGs.
Well, I'm a steamroller, babe.
High on this list is The Section, an LA-based outfit anchored by a rhythm section of bassist Leland Sklar and Russ Kunkel on drums, along with Craig Doerge on keyboards and Danny Kortchmar on guitar. They made musical magic. The Section's roots actually sprung up in New York in the mid-60s. Danny Cooch Kortchmar, an up-and-coming young guitarist, joined a group called The Flying Machine, featuring a very young James Taylor. While The Flying Machine never took off and James headed to London, Taylor would ultimately be the reason that The Section came together.
I've seen fire and I've seen rain.
They were assembled in the studio by producer Peter Asher as the backing band for James Taylor's breakthrough album.
It's time to rock by my sweet baby Jane.
Then, after recording Taylor's Sweet Baby James, in quick succession, The Section played on Carole King's Tapestry album and Joni Mitchell's beloved Blue.
But I like you, yes, I like you fine.
Working with Linda Ronstadt, Jackson Browne, David Crosby and Grand Nash, Warren Zevon, and so many more from a golden era of singer-songwriters. They were dubbed the Mellow Mafia.
You've got a friend.
Cooch, Leland Sklar, the maestro of the electric bass, drumbeat major Russ Kunkel, and keyboardist Craig Doerge completed an aggregation that Mr. Taylor nicknamed The Section.
It's too late, baby, now it's too late.
Cooch had also started playing with another singer-songwriter. Her name was Carole King, and The Section played a central role in the recording of her landmark debut album.
Well, let me tell you about it.
With Taylor's producer Peter Asher at the helm, The Section helped Linda Ronstadt record some of her finest work. Jackson Browne, they were the session men, bringing some of his greatest songs to life. In the 70s, The Section also recorded three highly acclaimed albums under their own name. On many dates, they were joined by multi-instrumentalist David Lindley and Cooch's old pal, Waddy Wachtel. And with the late, great Warren Zevon, there is no better example of his backing muscle and acumen than the immortal Werewolves of London. In recent decades, they have all added their sound and expertise to a variety of artists. Lee has the distinction of being one of the most recorded musicians of all time, playing on over 2,500 albums, including extensive work with Phil Collins. Danny also collaborated with Don Henley on his debut solo album, Building the Perfect Beast. Craig Doerge's work with the group and members of Crosby, Stills, and Nash has been essential to their live sound. And Russ Kunkel continues to perform, but has also had a noteworthy producing career, including work with both Jimmy Buffett and Carly Simon.
Three guys who were the original band. And please welcome Danny Kortchmar, Cooch, Lee Sklar, Rusty Kunkel.
When James and Carole reunited for a tour in 2010, it was The Section who were essential right there behind them. For nearly a half century, across the recording studios of LA, The Section has played the score of a cultural soundtrack, carving a signature sensibility and rhythmic pulse behind iconic songs and artists. At a truly memorable musical moment in time, The Section were the house band that defined a generation, and they are indeed most worthy inductees into the 2018 Namm Tech Hall of Fame.